Sweet salmon, I... Oh, we started? Hello there. I guess some introductions are in order. Dear listeners, I am, of course, Veryl, the one and only. And this lot are the Cambridge University Light Entertainment Society, or CULES, short. This programming is brought to you in aid of the British Red Cross's Ukraine appeal. Please give generously. It is a very good cause, and there should be a link somewhere in the description or something. Now, all that remains is for you to sit back, listen up, and enjoy the Veryl Show! just kidding. Okay, maybe the Veryl Show didn't get approved by the producers, but we can all at least agree I'm the star, right? Right? Nah.
Born from the fire, ashes and smoke, from the dust of the liars who found your new home in a pit of beggars and sinners and wine. You will be found, a child of mine. From the ruins, you will learn how to strike matches in the dark, to wear a small and soul patches on my heart. Where's left unspoken?
Bad in my brain, left unspoken.
I'll leave my heart in the dirt. Don't tell me I overexert. I'm not the one, I'm not in need. You'll push me out or rip me up until I bleed.
Can I get some sex in the woods?
Depends if you can deal with the sticks of the arse.
Oi, sourpuss, did you hear me or not? Man's thirsty.
Perhaps you'd stop being so crude and you'd get what you asked for. God, you're adults, stop acting like it.
I'd watch your mouth if I were you.
Know what you're getting into before you challenge me, bucko. You don't even look strong enough to hold up a pint glass.
Why, you...
What my esteemed colleague is trying to say is they'd be delighted to get your drink for you. Just sit yourself down and we'll bring it right over.
You'd better.
Aww, I wanted to see the fight.
Dagger, what's gotten into you? I know you're hurt, but I've never seen you like this.
I just feel like such a fool, Gwyn. I'm experiencing far too many emotions all simultaneously, and I feel like a ticking time bomb. To top it all off, I feel so humiliated. The lengths I went to defend him. And you were right all along. All the things I did for him. Jeez, it was such a pushover.
You can say that again.
Shh. All the red flags just... look like flags when you're seeing things through rose-tinted spectacles, Dagger. You were full of hope that he'd help everyone here. So, it's no wonder. He'll get through it. You're tough. Just don't do anything stupid, okay? I don't want you coming into the night shift tomorrow with bright green hair.
Right.
Don't worry, folks. I'm sure it's just my husband messing around. He's the doorman tonight. Who's there?
I don't think that's Dad, Mum.
A really large male pigeon?
Hands in the air!
Let go of me!
Dad!
I said put your hands in the air.
We have the warrant for all of your arrests, as commanded by President Tiger himself, for the illegal production and consumption of alcohol, for breaking curfew, and the defacing of Phoenix Garcia's resting place with politically charged graffiti and gang tags.
Dagger, what the hell did you do?
I'm sorry, Gwen. I was angry. I didn't think. What are
you
looking at?
You can come with us peacefully, or we can do this the hard way. It's your choice.
Okay. I hear you.
Mom, what are you doing? Mom, stop!
It's all right, Gwen. The fish will see us through.
What? Oh, right.
Boy, do you guys have some weird sayings down here.
Dagger, push the red button under the bar. I can't reach from here.
Keep what is it?
It activates the singing fish plaques.
Be quiet.
Just trust me, will you? You got us into this mess.
I told you not to move.
What on earth?
What is the meaning of this?
Enough! We don't have all day.
That's the thing about living with polluted factory air offices. You soon get used to it. Now!
Let's get her!
No!
Mum installed the smoke machines as a distraction so we can escape in an emergency. Not to get ourselves arrested trying to fight.
If those drunkards would rather take up the opportunity to punch an officer than to get away, that's on them, but we have to go.
But how? There's only one way in.
There's a secret tunnel at the back. How do you not know this? We told you when we employed you.
What's the place name? Sauce.
For goodness sake. Come on, both
of you. Go away, you brutes! You did not say the secret tunnel went through the sewers!
Well, when you're escaping, you've not got much choice.
Move out of the way, kids. We ain't sticking around to find out if those officers are following us.
When I find out which one of those wolves pulled that stunt at Garcia's funeral, I'm gonna wring their neck.
Gwen, I'm so sorry.
Why? Why did you do it? Were you trying to get back at the wolves? Or were you trying to get back at Phoenix? He's dead, Dagger. You know President Kyger, the Mage Guild, the Upper Dwellers, they all tar us with the same brush. To them, we are all wolves. Of all a threat they have to quash. You put us all in danger. My parents arrested because you were trying to upset a dead man. Well done.
I'll hand myself in. I'll tell them it was me and it had nothing to do with the wolves.
You were a lone wolf, so to speak. Sorry.
You think they'll believe you? What will it take to crush your belief that Upper Dwellers are good people who listen to reason?
At least come back to Farron's with me. You'll be safe there.
Looks like I don't have a choice, thanks to you. We might not even be able to go back there. They could be raiding the entire warren for all we know.
I hope not.
Let's go then.
Why are you coming? You've no reason to.
Why pass up an opportunity for a slumber party? It's not like my uncle will miss me anyways. Like you said before, Gwyn. Safety in numbers.
Excellent. At least I have someone to talk to whilst I'm ignoring Dagger.
Why do I keep ruining everything? Maybe I wasn't ever supposed to be here. Perhaps the universe meant for me to perish in that accident. Maybe that's why I lost the necklace. Someone up there trying to tell me something. Who even was I? Who even am I? I guess it doesn't matter. A burden is what I am.
What are you doing up on the roof all by yourself? I haven't found you moping up here since you were a teen.
I'm a monster! monster, Farron. I let my emotions get the better of me. I was selfish, and now people are getting hurt. Gwyn's parents are in jail!
You're human, Dagger. And humans aren't always logical. We're reckless, and we make mistakes. Lord knows I've made my fair share. But we learn from them. Grow. Become better. Gwyn will be angry at you for a while, but she'll come around. Just so long as your apology wasn't empty.
It wasn't. I'll do better. I'll make things right.
I know you will. Here, McStuffins will keep you company till you're ready to come down.
You are come. Take Pip-Pip. He'll keep you company till we come home.
You're Petrock. Thank you, dearie.
What is it, Dagger?
Oh, nothing. Just a surprise you kept my childhood toy after all this time.
Oh, well, McStuffins' family, eh?
Yeah. Just when I thought I couldn't make a bigger mess of things, huh, McStuffins? What do I do now? Not much of a talker, are you?
Dagger! Psst! Dagger!
Am I hallucinating, or did you just speak, McStuffins?
No, Dagger, it's me.
Who's there? Come out of the shadows!
I was hoping you'd recognize my voice. Since my face isn't really looking like my face at the moment.
Step into the light so I can see you. Now!
It's me. It's Phoenix.
Is this some kind of sick joke?
No. I know it's hard to believe given my current unfortunate appearance. But it is me.
Funnily enough, I don't remember Phoenix having pointy teeth, horns, a tail, and, I don't know, being purple?
I know, but just hear me out. I was cursed. Now I know why they call you Dagger.
Who are you and what do you want? How do you know my name? Who sent you? The wolves? The guild? Because all I see is an insignificant, lily-livered imper who was one fart away from shitting himself.
What's gotten into you, Bugs?
Phoenix? And how many others did he call that? Because, do you know what I found out? After all this time, thinking he cared about me, cared about the people suffering in the Warren, thinking that we would change things together. Turns out, I was just his little plaything that would do his bidding. Well, I'm fed up with being used as a doormat, doing anything to please people who are giving me nothing in return. So if you truly are Phoenix, you'd better hurry up and explain things before I send you back to the crypt in Guilderstone Cathedral.
Wow, Bugs. I'm not used to you speaking like this.
Don't call me that. Explain.
Well, it's like I said. Nox, the leader of the Pan and Mage Guild, cursed me. Turned me into this. An impa, of all things. They didn't get what they wanted at the negotiations. I didn't know what else to do, so I faked my death. And I spent the last few days asking around the Warren for you. Because I needed help.
Why did you come to my doorstep? Well, rooftop. With all your problems. Why, for the love of all things mechanical, did you fake your own death instead of undoing the enchantment yourself? You're a mage, aren't you?
You can't possibly believe I didn't try. I don't know what Nox did, but I'm powerless. Magic gone. Poof.
Then why didn't you go to the guild for help? We all know Pannon's mages have less powerful magic. I'm sure they could have cured you in seconds. I'm sure it was just some silly prank. This Nox would have known better than to harm the son of Gilda Emerson. God, you are so dramatic!
Because my mother threw me off the guild, that's why. They all thought I wasn't capable enough. A grievance. So how could I go to them for help after that? The negotiations were my last chance, and because of you, it all got messed up. This is all your fault.
My fault? How is this my fault? Don't come here playing the victim when you're the one who has caused me pain.
The stupid glitter bomb you put in the Guildercloak package exploded at the meeting. Bet you thought it was cute. You could have at least put a note in there like, warning, explodes, don't take this into a really important meeting that your whole life and career depends on.
I have no idea what... Feral. Feral must have snuck it into the package. I knew one was missing from my bag. But you know what? All of my friends could see you for what you really were. Maybe, if you were competent in the first place, you wouldn't have gotten kicked out. So if the only reason you're here is to shout at me and blame me, then you can leave, because I've had enough.
No. That's not the only reason. Can I just say, you look absolutely stunning in the moonlight.
I am immune to your charm offensive. Spit it out!
I came because Nox. Before they cursed me, they took your necklace.
My necklace? What do you mean, my necklace? Don't tell me you were actually telling the truth when you said you wore a locket with my picture in.
Hell no. I mean... the necklace you wore all the time when we first met. I liked the look of it. Thought it would go well with some outfits I had, so... I took it.
You stole my necklace?
Yes, yes, I know. I'm sorry. But I was hoping you could tell me why Nox would want it. It must have some importance if they would take such a risk to snatch it. It might help me figure out how to get uncursed.
I don't know. Maybe they are just a thieving magpie like you are. And yes, it was important. Important to me. It was the only thing I had when I was found alone, injured, and wandering around the Warren without a clue who I was. It was a piece of my identity that I'd hoped one day would help me remember where I came from, who my family was. I was shattered when I thought I'd lost it. So how about you stop thinking about yourself for once and apologize properly?
I can see coming here was a mistake. I'm convinced that necklace is not all it seems. Otherwise, why would Nox bother? I thought you, of all people, would know something about it.
Wait! It's past curfew. You'll end up in the clink if you get caught. By the state of you, you look like you've already gotten into one too many scrapes.
I've managed up until now. Thank you very much.
And... we could make a deal.
I beg your pardon?
If I help you get information on the necklace, you would be one step closer to being uncursed, and I would be one step closer to finding out where I came from.
Yes, and...
So, if I help you un-imper yourself and return you back to your human self, you will swallow your pride and go to your mother about, firstly, releasing those arrested. Then, diplomatically sorting out the situation in the Warren, improving conditions, wages and such, and give us a voice.
I'm not even a part of the guild anymore. You think I could face them after the humiliation I endured?
That may be the case, but Gilda Emerson is your mother. She will listen to her son. As for facing the guild, suck it up. You are so self-important. You need to be taken down a notch.
Sucking it up to the guild has never worked before. If you know what I mean.
Honestly!
Anyway, Bugs, what do you have that I need? I could go and find out for myself.
If you had any contacts, you would have gone to them first. I may not know anyone, but I sure as hell know Farinwood. And, as proved by your actions thus far, there's no way you can navigate this alone. Trust me, sticking around with you is a personal sacrifice of the greater good. Come on, actually do something well-meaning in your life, and make good on the promise you made me once upon a time.
You know I had my fingers crossed behind my back when I agreed to help the Warren a few months ago. Fine, you've got a deal. But only if we find out some worthwhile info. If this turns up nothing, then I'm not stepping foot in that palace ever again.
I know you probably want to be left alone, but you need to eat something. Who are you?
What is it with Warren rats and threatening people? What's wrong with hello? Nice to meet you.
Dagger, get behind me while I sort out this cretin.
Wait, Baron, I know him. He's my friend. He was just joking, right?
Right.
Sorry, son. Oh. You can't be too careful nowadays. What's a bit of threatening between friends, eh?
Oh.
Dagger, you never mentioned this fellow before.
No, this is Fiend. Fiend! He's, shy.
Fiend? Really?
Don't know what you're complaining about. It's appropriate. See? Poor thing has to whisper what he wants to me.
And what is it that he wants?
To come inside. It's getting pretty chilly out here.
Of course. Dagger's friends are always welcome.
Finally, kid. I thought you were never gonna come down. Hey, who's Demon Boy?
This is Fiend. He's a friend. Baron, can I speak to you a minute? I need to ask you something. Alone.
Of course. Veryl can show our guest downstairs. I'm sure Gwyn and Kit would love to meet him.
Wait, Dagger, shouldn't I come with you?
Aw, don't worry, Fiend. There's no need to be nervous. They don't bite. Here, take McStuffins.
Come on, Demon Boy. Let's see if you know how to potty.
What have I gotten myself into?
So what is it you want to ask me?
Do you know anyone who knows a lot about antiques? Or, unusual and rare items? I figured you might have an idea, seeing as you know the Warren inside and out.
Why? Has that friend of yours got something to pawn?
No. I want to find out about my necklace. The one you found me with.
Oh, I see.
It's not that I don't appreciate you or this new one you made me.
No, you misunderstand. I'm just surprised that you've never asked before.
Oh. Well, truth is, I guess I've just been scared. All I remember from that day is fire, smoke, and pain. And that pain has lived with me since. And everything has always been so great here in the Warren. Well, you know what I mean. I thought that searching for something else was selfish.
Dagger, everyone wants to know who they are. Our roots are important. It doesn't mean we don't appreciate what we have. Plus, I already did some asking around.
Really?
As you know, when we first found you, I inquired about you. Went to the police to file a report to see if we could find your family. But I think the political unrest was so great at the time, what with the royal family being assassinated and President Keigler taking over. Your case probably got put to the bottom of the pile.
Right.
But when you lost your necklace, I visited every pawn shop in the Warren and even risked some upper quarter antique shops just in case someone had nicked it and sold it on. No one had seen high tail of it or even heard of it, but a few times a name cropped up. Someone these shops all seemed to trade with. Annesley, a halfling who lives on the outskirts of Guilderstone in a village called Autumnwood, who knows a thing or two about rare pieces. I suppose an occupational hazard for being hundreds of years old.
Do you mind if I skip out on work tomorrow to pay this Annesley a visit?
Problem is, getting there. It's so far out that going by blimp is really the only practical way if you want to get there fast. But that's a mode of transportation we could never afford. Not if we want to keep up with payments to Dr. Campbell. Hitchhiking is dangerous and would take too long, meaning missing out on work days. Especially now you can't do extra shifts at the pit stop.
Oh, yeah.
It's disgraceful that the barrier between you and finding out more about yourself is money. That's why I never told you. I didn't want to see your heart broken again.
It's okay, Farron. I guess I was foolish to think that I could chase this with everything that's going on. I'll find a way one day. I've waited this long. A little extra won't hurt.
No! Not the salmon! Anything but the salmon!
Phoenix! Are you awake?
Of course I'm awake. Have you tried sleeping with horns?
No, but I thought you'd be fine considering you sleep with anything that moves. You're an expert at being horny.
Really? And you say I'm immature.
Mice aren't supposed to be that big. Oh, no! I can't do the tango!
This is not the time to argue. We risk waking everyone up. We need to get to the blimp station before dawn.
Why?
I didn't get a chance to tell you last night, but there's someone in Autumnwood Village who can help us with the necklace mystery. Now get up!
I hope this is all worth it and this guy knows something so this curse can hurry up and be broken. If I have to spend any longer than necessary like this, so help me.
I don't understand why you're so pent up about it. What's so bad about being an imper?
I'd rather not live out the rest of my days as a primary color.
Purple is a secondary color, Phoenix.
Plus, I could never return to the upper quarter. Trying to make my way through was hellish. People got creative with the insults, I can tell you that. I was starting to think I should write them down for future use.
Wow, I can't imagine what that's like. About time you faced up to how upper dwellers treat us.
Whatever. Let's just hurry up and do whatever it is we are doing. What are we doing?
I was just about to ask you the same thing.
Guys, what are you all doing here?
We followed you, of course.
I personally wanted to sleep in, but Grim is sus about your new pal.
And I was right to be. Phoenix.
I know, right? What a plot twist! We heard everything you guys were saying.
Why did you keep this from us?
Phoenix and I have a deal. If I help him break his curse, he'll go to the Mage Guild about the issues in the Warren. Guildernox stole my necklace, the original one, and we think it has something to do with that. We're going to Autumnwood to get more information.
Like he was so excellent at keeping that promise before. I can't believe after everything, you're still willing to trust him. You're just running away, Dagger. May I remind you my parents are still in prison because of you?
I know, Gwyn. I'm sorry. I really, truly am. I'm trying my best to fix things. I left Farron a note telling him everything, what we're hoping to achieve. If you'd let me explain.
If you want to fix things, stay with us. Fight.
Look, I despise the guy as much as you, Gwyn, but can't we at least try? I don't want to see any more people hurt either. Maybe Dagger's way is worth it.
And where has Dagger's way gotten us so far? Huh? I see. You'd rather go off with that upper dweller Ponce. If loyalty means nothing to you, I'm going.
Gwyn, please!
Screw the lot of you!
So, what's the plan, kid?
The quickest way to Autumnwood is by blimp. But blimps are hella bougie and expensive. Luckily for us, blimps are stationed here overnight. All we have to do is stow away. Not lucky for us, the elevators won't be operational, and the stairways are locked up until they open.
So, how are we supposed to get up there?
We climb, of course.
Are you mad?
Unequivocally.
You gotta use smaller words, Kit. I don't think the demon boy understands. See you kids at the top! Whee!
I think I'm actually going to die before we make it anywhere.
Come down to the warren where little rabbits run. Come and play in the coal and the dust. You trust me. Take my hand. They can't catch us here.
By our contract.